Young at Heart is brought to you by the Dental Implant Institute of Las Vegas and Canyon Gate Medical Group, an OBDS affiliate.
Fairy tales can come true. It can happen to you if you're young at heart.
The next hour brings entertainment and information for those of you who are young at heart. Here are your hosts, Lynn Peterson and Al Jones.
If you're young at heart.
Hey, welcome to another edition of Young at Heart with myself, Lynn Peterson, and...
How you like that? No. Jones. You don't like that?
You sound like a sick dog when you do that. Don't. Roof, 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 roof. Meow, meow, meow. I already have two pets at home. I like my friend Al.
Lynn, they say young at heart, and so if I don't act young, then hey, then people will think that I'm not young.
We know you. Everybody in town knows Al.
They do?
I never get out of the... when I'm walking with you...
Yes.
We never get out of a place in time.
People stop.
Because people
say
stop
they want to talk.
They don't recognize me. I mean, I'm just... you know, I'm just...
Well, I tell you, when I go to the store some more, then what you do is be with me and I'll tell them who you are.
Okay. I'm kind of like Dean Martin to your Jerry Lewis.
Yes!
This up... what do you call him? Up man? Straight man? Yeah, straight man.
Don't do it like
we
that.
We got a lot to talk about in five
yes,
minutes, and we
let's
just
start.
Wasted about one of those five.
That's the introduction. We have to do that.
I see.
What?
Our producer's telling us 4 minutes. Better.
Okay.
She's got a spasm in her hand. I don't know. Anyway.
Let's get with
There's some serious things coming up. You want to talk about this one?
Yes. Folks, I'm going to be serious right now. Let's make a difference. Benefit Poker Run and Spaghetti Dinner, March the 5th. That's 2011. To benefit the Smiley and Broadhead families, hosted by the Maverick Saloon and Dance Hall.
Saloon.
What did I say?
Saloon. The French version.
That's the French version. Okay, saloon. And Dance Hall. The run is open to everyone from motorcycles, cars, walkers, joggers, horseback riders. Registration begins at 9 a.m. until 10 a.m. at the Maverick.
At Mavericks, yeah.
That's 340 East Mesquite. Yeah.
So it's the Maverick Saloon, and it's going to be March 5th. Just remember, if you want to register, it's $25, and it's for a run. Anyone on motorcycles, horseback riders, cars, whatever. And it's to benefit. There's also poker. What's a poker run?
Poker run.
Are they going to play poker while they're running?
Well, sometimes, you know.
Yeah, and you get spaghetti with that afterwards.
Well,
and
of
anyway,
course
that's
do.
March 5th, so we will be telling you. No, we won't. It'll be happening next week, this coming weekend.
Well, also, for those interested in dinner only, $5 donation.
Oh, okay, $5 donation if you just want to go for dinner. We also have the Spring Fling Cowboy Thing. I like that. From Arts Council. They're inviting you to join them for a fun evening of entertainment, door prizes, grub, no host bar. That's also March 5th, and that's 7 to 10 in the evening. When does this take place?
Well,
9 to 10 a.m.
9 to 10 a.m.
is the race.
Right.
So you can go to both things, and it'd be wonderful because this all the proceeds for this fundraiser will benefit the Arts Council of Pahrump, which is a great thing.
Right.
We need arts here.
Yeah, and the telephone number for this one, the Benefit Poker Run, is 751-9988. That's 751-9988. And Arnie's Lounge, Sugar Magnolia, the Hideaway and Valley Bar, those also are
participating
in that.
And just
what
one really quick, Pahrump Valley Women's Luncheon. It's the National Women's Week, and that's going to be next Tuesday, March 8th, from 11:30. To 1:30, and it's the Pahrump Nugget Buffet, and everybody knows where that is. It's on Highway 160. So that's Pahrump Valley Women's Luncheon at 11:30 to 1:30, and it's a network lunch. It's a great thing because you can network, and you never know. You might make some contacts business-wise as well as maybe friends. We got a great guest coming up. Yeah, for our show. Yeah, it's a show today. And... his name is Ira Sternberg.
And yay!
We don't know what to make of him. He's a writer, radio show host, talk show,
crazy man.
He's been around a long time.
A Renaissance guy.
A Renaissance. When you say Renaissance, what does that mean when you say Renaissance?
Renaissance, a man of all things.
Of all things, is that right?
Yeah.
All things.
I think that's what it means. Or he's really, really old. You know, he knows a lot about Shakespeare. We can ask him about what Willie was really like in real life, you know?
That's an idea.
Yeah, there you go.
He'll know that, won't he?
Oh my gosh, we have digressed.
Yes,
we do digress.
What's on the show today?
Oh, the show. We also have the vault. The vault. You know, when I don't put my contacts in, I really do need to wear these and keep them on. We have Tom at the vault, and that's an interview with the Rhonda Dead, and Ed Harding from Canyon Gate, as well as our visit at the Nugget with some of the kid chefs.
Yes.
My glasses are crooked.
Would be chefs.
Look
at this. That's right.
I don't know if it's my head or if I need to, you know, get my glasses fixed.
It is spring.
It is spring. We're in the Japanese garden in Pahrump. Y'all didn't know about it. We'll tell you about it later.
Spring is busting
out. Be back right after this commercial.
Stay tuned.
Welcome back to Young at Heart. Our next guest, as promised, is Ira Sternberg.
Hello, Lynn. Hello,
Al. Yeah.
Hey,
greetings.
We introduced you as a Renaissance man because we're going to let you tell us all the wonderful things that.
Well, I just want to put out for the record that even though we've not met before, Lynn, I know a lot about you, but Al and I met when I was here the last time several years ago when I was here with the Lieutenant Governor, Lorraine Hunt.
That's all right. All right.
And he looks the same, which is not that much of an improvement.
So, what?
Well,
wait, I was only kidding.
We don't worry about that. That's a funny story. You're talking about Lorraine Hunt. She sang with us once. When I had Woody and the gang, and we were doing the initiation or inaugural dinner for Chamber of Commerce here in Pahrump, and she was the guest speaker, and we had her come up on stage and sing. She was good.
Did she ever sing at Upper St. Clair High like you went to?
Oh, my God. He knows everything about me, and this is really spooky, and he won't tell me. Anyway, this is not about us.
No, you're absolutely right, but I do want to wish a premature happy birthday to Al.
Yeah,
thank you,
because
hey.
He's going to be turning 60 in March, so I just want to get that out.
Do you want to sing happy birthday with me?
No.
I don't
sing.
I'll
sing it when it's actually your birthday.
Oh, will you do that?
I'll even take you out on your birthday.
Ooh.
I promised Pat to take her out for Christmas. I have done that.
Can I pick the place?
Yes. If you give me, I'll give you three choices, and we're taking up Iris time.
It's okay. So here's the thing.
No. Let's
you guys were nice enough to invite me over here. My background basically is...
He has Cliff Notes.
I have Cliff Notes.
Oh, my God.
Or Cliff Jones, which is your brother. But anyway, the point I'm trying to make, do I get to speak at some point, Pat? I just want to know.
Right now.
Okay.
Eventually.
You know, I actually host my own show, and now I understand how the guests feel.
We're giving you back some of your own
medicine. That's okay.
We were told to do that, you know.
It's okay. Lunchtime with Ira, and then it's also called Nighttime with Ira because it airs on KUNV 91.5 every Thursday.
Wherever you are.
Right. 91.5. Mm-hmm. And also at KUNV.org if you want to listen online. And it's every Thursday at 6. And it may change to 6:30, but just go there at 6 and you'll find me. And what we do is we interview just a wide range of people. Everybody from, I just finished interviewing Tim Allen, and I'm going to be interviewing Roy Clark, and we interview authors and celebrities and entertainers. Anything that has to do with the Las Vegas area.
Right. Mm.
And it started out originally as a radio show, then became a TV show, and now it's back to being a radio show because we started out at the Hilton.
So you're not doing the TV show right
not
now?
Not yet, but we're going to be doing that shortly. But what we did is we started out as a live radio show, which Al would know about because he was live when radio was live, and at WGN. And then
You mean radio's not alive anymore?
It can be. I'm not sure Al is. But the point is, I'm only picking on Al, but...
Oh,
we all love.
I'm waiting.
That's love. That's love.
So anyway, so that's it. Started out as a radio show. Then we started to videotape it for the hotel rooms. Then we became a TV show with also a radio feed.
You interview people in hotel rooms?
No, not in hotel rooms. No. It was in the hotel. But then we were on the monorail. We're all over the place.
Cool.
So I do that. And then I'm also a writer, and I've been writing forever. But used to write for a lot of publications in town. And I know you're going to ask me about one thing that I do, which is normally not available to the public, but if anybody's interested, they contact you guys, and I'm sure you have some way that people can contact you, we will send it to them. But that's the Las Vegas Notebook, which has been, I think we're in our 11th year now, which is every week I send it out to a group of people that receive it, VIPs and others and such, and it's just commentary on what's happening in Las Vegas.
Yeah. Mm. So the Notebook itself, is that on your radio station, part of the radio show?
No, it's not. I use the Notebook to promote who's on the show.
All right, how do they get to the Notebook again if they want to
They have to contact you guys.
Oh, they have
it's
to contact
us. It's sent by email only. It's not yet. Although I have a website, I haven't put it on the website yet.
Got it.
Lynn's a little slow.
Yes, I am. And you know why?
Why, Lynn?
My son left yesterday.
For the Coast Guard.
Oh,
with that blonde that he was dating?
Ooh.
Redhead.
Redhead, sorry.
6 foot redhead. Oh. No, I don't even know her name.
You know, Lynn's been gone for like 12 years in Peron initially. I just want you to know.
It started in 5 years.
Yeah, now it's 12 years.
12 years, yeah.
But I haven't changed either, other than the hair, have I? I mean, my hair
is longer. No, you haven't changed. You're the same. And you are.
You're always fashionable because you went to Bonner Fashion College. So, you know, that whole thing works to your advantage.
He's been on my website for my album.
He knows all about you.
Yeah. He was on my CD website. I got it. Never mind.
That's right.
We're still digressing. We keep talking about us. We should be talking
about
Ira.
You,
Ira.
So anyway, I've had an opportunity to interview all kinds of interesting people. I mean, that's a fascinating part. When we
Absolutely.
Did the TV version, we were interviewing four people a show. So we got it'd be a mix of an entertainer, an author, someone that was very important in the community, et cetera, et cetera. I haven't had you guys on yet.
Would you?
Yeah, we might.
Yeah.
We might work that out. Can you make it into Vegas?
Oh, yes. Gosh,
you know, it took me 6 hours to get here from Vegas because I hitchhiked.
And we have bicycles.
The guy picked me up on his burro out at Red Rock. And by the time I got in, hell, what's wrong?
And the highway is completed by the time you got in.
Oh,
right?
Yeah, it was totally completed. It was one lane, so I had to share it with the cars.
I can't help it.
Oh, wow.
Are you all right now?
I can have some fun.
He's so funny, man. You know, he pulled a thing on me way back.
Oh, no, I wouldn't do that to you.
It did way back. It was just funny, though. It was
do you want
funny.
To tell them the story?
I know.
Okay, then I won't.
It's just like a guy. We were just talking about this earlier. He won't tell me how he knows all this information about me. He doesn't want to tell a story about how they go back.
But it does, but it was so funny. It had to do with the dinner and then Pat and so forth. And he sent the message back.
That is correct.
Did it have to do with anything about like wine or going through
Al
your
and I
nose
can't discuss it because you're here.
So yeah, you're here, so
yeah, you're here. We can't discuss it.
So just, I think it's fascinating that, you did things like going out in the community on the monorail or in hotels.
Oh, yeah, we actually did the show on the monorail. If you believe that, we had the whole TV crew.
How much fun is that? Mm-hmm.
And what we had to do is we had to coordinate it with the guests. We only could get one guest on the train at a time because we had the crew. We had our own.
Was that the conductor of the monorail?
No, we had our own car. and we had the crew, which was a 3-person crew.
Wow.
Me as the host, and then the guest. And then what we did is we timed it out in each. Full circle of the monorail was about 15 minutes.
Right.
So we had the next guest waiting at the Hilton station at the monorail, and we dropped off the first guest, picked up the second guest, and started up again.
Right.
Wow. And at the end, we had the band. Oh, we had the band in the train too, and the band played a number as well.
That's so cool. So you're talking that you are going to go back into a television show sometime in the
future. Right. We're talking to a couple of venues about bringing it back because it started out, as I say, as a radio, but we had so much fun with it as a television show. If you go to YouTube, you can see some of the episodes.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. And what's the name of the
Just
show?
Just Lunchtime with Ira, if you go to that channel.
Okay, same thing. Lunchtime with Ira.
Right.
And, my gosh, you interview so many great people. Does one interview stand out other than with us?
Ironically.
Very good.
Well, actually, yes, it does. I think of all the people, and I've interviewed most of the stars, but I think the one that I always enjoyed was Bob Mayhew, who is Howard Hughes's right-hand man.
Oh, my
God.
Yeah,
gosh. I remember that one.
He had such interesting information and background on Howard Hughes in that whole period of time in Las Vegas.
Wow. That would have been
really
cool.
So I think that probably was my favorite interview.
Yeah.
But you get used to it when you're dealing with, celebrities and entertainers are just people, like Al. And so when you deal with them, you just take them as who they are.
Well, especially as you've been in Las Vegas for 30 years. Right. I mean, like you said, you see everybody on the strip. You get to know them that, they are. They go to the bathroom. They take showers,
I don't know if that's the case, but they are human in every other way. And years ago when I was reviewing shows, we would go backstage and get to really know the performer in the sense that after you've seen them 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, times you become much more friendly and they know you, you know them.
Did you interview my uncle?
Who's your uncle?
It was Foster Brooks. He was.
I did. Actually, that was one of the people I did not have a chance to interview.
God rest his soul.
Foster Brooks. He was an interesting character. He was
very good. Brooks. Scared a lot of people when he first went on stage.
But he was good.
Because they thought it was seriously drunk.
Yeah, but he was.
Seriously
right.
drunk. Not like right. we are here.
Right. What else you want to leave with us, Ira, before our time runs out?
I mean, we really need to have you back, because 10 minutes really is not a long time.
You mean it's already, we're already gone?
No, not yet.
Oh.
You
were going to tell us about I was going to mention about it. One of my comments on the notebook was about the fact that Senator Reid had talked to the state legislature about getting rid of legalized prostitution. And I thought, wouldn't it be better first to put the cart before the horse or the horse before the cart and eliminate illegal prostitution?
Absolutely. I get it. You know what?
Yeah.
They'll always try and stop a woman making an honest living. Jeez. Now, you also may have a book.
I'm working on a book.
Your
producer,
Pat
Wall, is constantly on my case about trying to get the book done, but there's a couple. I'm veering between two or three different subjects.
Okay.
Since I've lived in Las Vegas, I've met a lot of interesting people over the years. Mm-hmm. I'm thinking about that, or maybe just be a humor book, which would be different than this interview.
I would read either one, but in your humor book, would it be just like little vignettes, or would you incorporate stories with the humor where that came from?
It could be both.
Okay.
Yeah.
I think it'll be great.
Did your uncle know Charlie Sheen?
I asked him about that. You know, I really wanted to bring that. No.
No, okay.
Thank you. And you know, if he did, he'd turn him over his knee and spank him.
Oh. Yes. Well, Charlie, though, I really have to congratulate him because he turned over all of his drugs now to Walgreens Pharmacy. So
there you go. And, thank you, Ira, and we'll have you back.
Thank you so much.
We'll be right back.
Welcome to Young at Heart. I am Rhonda Van Winkle, and I'm here with Mr. Elliott from Las Vegas, Nevada. He has 24/7 private vaults. And it's a one-of-a-kind operation, and we want to talk to them all about it. So, hello, Mr. Elliott.
Yes,
so
ma'am.
Nice to
how
meet
are you?
I'm very well, thank you. You know, one of the first things I noticed when I came in here today is that you have these letters all over your walls. Can you tell me about them?
Yeah, these are comments of customers that have been here, and there's one bad one. The rest are all good, though.
Okay.
You know, you got to have somebody that says something bad.
But you put them all up then,
we
right?
We put them up, good, bad, right or wrong. It's immaterial. Everybody should know.
Very good. Mr. Elliott, can you tell us a little bit more about 24/7 private vaults?
Yeah, I'd be glad to. Number one, it was a crazy idea. I got into an argument at a bank. I don't want a bank telling me what to do.
Okay.
One of my daughters came down here one time and bought one of those electronic tickets that you buy on a computer. And naturally, her father, she didn't bring any credit card, social security card, driver's license, money. She didn't bring. Why? Because Dad is here.
Right.
This happens, you know. So I took her into the bank to sign on it, on my safe deposit box and my checking account. They wouldn't accept her because she didn't have a credit card, a driver's license, Social Security card. I said, could I have a little courtesy once in a while? I don't get any interest on my money, just a little courtesy. If you don't like it, leave. Get the manager. The manager came over and told me the same thing. I thought about it for about 2 seconds, which is all I take time to think about. I said, all right, get my money. I had $15,000 in cash in the bank. They told me they would give me $3,000 in cash and $12,000 in check. That is a no-no. I don't know if your check's any good. I put cash in, I would like to get cash out. Well, one word led to the other. It got a little heated. They were going to call the police. I said, I've got a better idea. I'll call up some consumer reporters, let them come down here and see what this bank looks like. And you know, that's the one with the horses that run around in circles.
I couldn't imagine what bank that would be.
Yeah, I can't imagine either. I have to clean up after them anyway. Anyway, 3 minutes later, we're walking out with the $15,000, and my daughter, who has a PhD, says, Dad, you didn't sign for it. I said, well, he didn't ask me. We just walked out. I went home and I thought about it. I checked with an attorney. I want to find out if there's a code number for banks. You know, like law, you know, about the Congress, whatever they do up there.
Yeah.
And we went to an attorney that I know very well, and he said he couldn't find any code numbers. Well, if there's no code, that means there's no law. You know, something like that. That's it. I settled it. I looked around, found this location. I like it. It's near the airport. Near good transportation. I opened up. My biggest problem here came from the city. They wanted me to go to the Federal Depository or the Federal Reserve to get a license. So finally I told them I'm going to open up without a license. I'll get a generator. I'll make my own electricity. That's all you need anyway. The landlord supplies water, so you can't shut that off. Get it right down the thing. Finally, it came down to a license. I said, I need a license, all right? They didn't know what to do. I said, what's the cheapest license you got? He said, a warehouse license. Is there anything cheaper than that? Yes, there's a small warehouse license, a mini warehouse. I'll take one of those. That's what I've got on the wall over there is a mini warehouse, license. And we have had people here now going on 11 years.
11 years in business.
Yeah.
And now you're known all over the United States.
Fact is, we have customers that come from Europe. The best one came from Switzerland. I said, how did you hear about me? Oh, he says, at the G20, everybody knows Elliot.
Really?
So I thought that was a compliment. Mm-hmm. And we have them from Europe. We have them from China. We have them from the United States.
So all over the world.
It's all over the world, basically.
Now, I know Forbes magazine did a very interesting article on you. What kind of response did you get from that?
Interesting. People looked at it, and they've been calling, and they've been coming. We keep it private. We keep it confidential.
So what would be a good reason to come to you? Why would somebody want to?
All right. Let's say, for instance, you're having, unfortunately, a divorce, a legal problem, litigation. The IRS wants something from you. What would they want from you? Blood or money? Both.
Mm-hmm. And all your information.
And that. I have no driver's license, no credit card, no name, no social security card. Your name don't mean a damn thing in this world anymore. It's the social security card that they know you by. Mm-hmm. We have nothing like that. We do have a picture, a digital picture, the iris of your eye. That's how you get in here. You get a PIN number, you get a password, and we take care of the privacy. That's as simple as that. If I get a subpoena here, I don't argue with anyone because I don't know your social security number or your name. We just send it back with a polite note, thank you for the social call. We never hear from them again.
So tell us a little bit more about this iris scan. How does it work?
The iris scan is a picture of the iris of your eye where oxygen is moving through. If no oxygen is moving through, there is a minor problem. You are deceased.
Oh. You know, that could be a problem.
That could be a problem, yeah. We'd like to have all our customers and clients in the vertical position, not the horizontal position, you know. They last longer vertically.
Uh-huh.
And they seem to be very happy with it. We want to make sure that you have a beneficiary. And the question is, why? Well, in case you have an accident. Mm-hmm. Well, I'm not going to die is the answer. Everybody dies sooner or later. And experience has shown it's good to have a beneficiary. We will put it in the code. There's no problem. Nobody will find out who it is. You find the trustee, put it in an envelope, give it to them, and they'll take care of it after you depart. It's been very effective. Any other questions?
So if there isn't a beneficiary, what do you do?
If there's no beneficiary, we hold it here for 2 years, send it to the state under the laws of escheat, and obey the law from that point on. And the state will hold it for 5 years. After that, I don't know what happens.
Right. So how does it work with the beneficiary?
Well, the beneficiary is put into a code number. Code number of numbers and letters. There is no name. We expect you to notify the beneficiary or have a trustee hold it for you in case you have a bad accident. Then he will notify the beneficiary.
That makes sense. So when someone comes to you, what all do they get?
Well, what they really get is nothing. They don't sign any papers. They don't fill out any papers. We don't want to know them. We make sure there's two proven rules here, and we enforce them. Rule one, no drugs. We have a police dog sniffing the place. Mm-hmm. The dog is very intelligent, by the way. It's a lot more than some people. Rule two, you got both keys. Don't lose them. You can come in here 24 hours a day. Security is on duty in there 24 hours a day. We have some 34 cameras around here making sure everything is quiet, safe, and secure.
Wow.
Would you like to take a look in the vault?
I would absolutely love to take a trip to the vault. And also, you wanted to share one of your most important employees with us, Sylvia.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Sylvia, would you mind stepping up to the bar? This is Sylvia Cordova.
Hi.
Hi, Sylvia. Have a seat. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
So tell us, what do you do here for Mr. Elliott?
I write up contracts, and I explain to people as they come in how it works. This is very unique business. It's like no other business that I've ever worked at. It's very private. We have security 24 hours a day. They can come in 2 in the morning. Once they take out a box between 10 and 6, then we show them how to have access 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
So that really does make it so much different than a secure safe deposit box at a bank.
Because correct.
You can come here 24/7 anytime you need to get to your things.
That's right.
You can get to them.
And we don't care what they put in the box as long as there's no narcotics, no hazardous materials. They can even keep a gun here, no ammunition. So it's completely private and very secure.
People worry about fires.
We've got, the building is sprinkled. We have an alarm system here, and we have actual live people on duty. So we have eyes watching all of those things.
And now what kind of people do you have that are here? I know you can't get so specific with names, but what type of people come in here?
Well, we have attorneys, judges, IRS agents, bankers. Mm-hmm. It's really a mix of people. Very interesting. Very interesting.
Great. Well, we'll take a look at the place now. I'm very interested to see the vault and see how you use the iris scan and
okay.
all those good things.
Well, we'll let the boss, Mr. Elliott, show you around.
Okay, it was very nice meeting you.
Thank you.
We're sorry, you are not identified. Please.
It won't let me in.
Oh, I'm sorry. Let me show you, all right?
Okay.
Identification is completed.
Over here, we're going to do a PIN numbers. You're going to come in with a PIN number. I'll do it because
okay.
you don't have one. Door opens up.
Well, Mr. Elliott, I really appreciate you taking me behind the scenes to see your vault and see how everything works. And I really liked and enjoyed meeting Sylvia also and getting her information. As far as Pahrump goes, what is it that you have that you wanted to offer to our Pahrump clients?
To all people of Pahrump, that means even the mayor, whoever it is, plus everybody else, if you come down to 24/7 private vaults, you're going to get two things. The first thing you're going to get is a lollipop. You can have one.
Oh my, thank you.
The second thing is everybody that wants to use the service here from Pahrump will receive 15 months, that's 3 months free, with every agreement. You get it as long as you stay with the company.
That's great. I'm sure that they'll be happy to hear that.
Believe me, no bank or credit union will ever do that for you.
No, they won't.
They won't even give you a lollipop.
No, they won't. You're one of a kind. Is that right?
Absolutely, in more ways than one.
All right.
Let's go.
All right. It was so nice meeting you.
Thank you. My pleasure.
Hello, welcome to Young at Heart. I am Rhonda Van Winkle, and I'm here again with Dr. Ed Harding from Canyon Gate Medical.
Hello,
how are
Rhonda.
You?
I'm doing well, thank you.
That's great. And last month, we introduced you to him, and we're going to be covering different topics each month. And so I was wondering, what topic is it that you wanted to talk about to Pahrump today?
I thought an interesting topic for today would be adult immunizations, which, you know, in general, I think when most people think about shots, they usually think about children getting shots.
Right.
And, you know, even for the viewers, you know, seniors, they probably think more of taking their grandkids to the pediatrician for shots. But in fact, certain shots are recommended for that age group. So I just thought it would be an interesting topic to talk about that.
So what are examples of ones that you would recommend to seniors or adults?
Sure. In general, there are 4 main shots that are pretty much recommended for all adults. One would be the flu shot, which you hear a lot about. We can go more into that. Another one would be the pneumonia shot. A third shot would be the shingles shot. And tetanus shot would be the 4th shot.
Okay, so let's start with flu shot. Give sure. me some examples of why you feel that the seniors should be getting these shots.
Sure. Well, the flu shot, as you probably know, you know, because you'll be in news, so you mm-hmm. see it all the time, mm-hmm. but that's an recommended annual shot. The shot that we would give in our office or that you would get at a pharmacy or at a grocery store is an inactivated shot, so it's not live. It is one time a year. It is this year it's called a 3-in-1 shot, and it's based actually on the most common viruses of the year previous. So this year's shot, for instance, is influenza A, influenza B, and H1N1, i.e. the swine flu that we heard about last year.
So is that why you need it once a year, because it's based on the year before?
That's exactly correct, because as you know, or I don't know if you do know, but viruses mutate quite frequently. They mutate. So, you know, they would, based on what's the most common viruses of the year previous, that's how they come up with the shot for this year.
Well, the most common thing I hear out there is, well, I don't get the flu shot because every time I get a flu shot, I get sick or I get the flu.
Yes.
What do you have to say about that?
Not possible. Side effects from the flu shot can be a sore arm where you get the shot, a little bit of a sore throat or fever. You can feel like you're a little bit sick, but the reality of it is that the shot itself is not live. It's actually a chopped up version of the virus.
Oh.
So, you know, you can't get sick from it.
Okay, very well. So, but it is normal maybe to have a little bit of...
It is. And actually, Rhonda, there are different versions of the flu shot out. There is actually a live version out that you could technically get a little bit ill from. That's called Flumist. It's a nasal version, but that's only approved in 2 to 49-year-olds. And typically, that's not one that you would get in a regular doctor's office or at, you know, at the pharmacy or the...
Okay, so for the seniors,
yes,
it's not a live...
That's
vaccine,
correct.
And
yes,
you're going to be just fine and get
absolutely
it every year.
Absolutely, yes.
Okay.
I mean, there are, you know, if you had a reaction to the flu shot before, if you have an egg allergy, I mean, the medical assistant or nurse who gives you the shot would ask you a bunch of questions. Providing there's no contraindication, once a year would be the recommendation.
Okay, great. Now, sometimes if you get the flu or you get sick, you get pneumonia. So tell us about the pneumonia shot.
Sure. Good, good question. The pneumonia shot... is a little different than when you get sick with the flu and get pneumonia. That could be, actually, influenza can cause pneumonia, but the pneumonia shot is actually gauged at a bacteria called strep pneumoniae. That shot, actually, after age 65 is once and done. So that's recommended, is to get it at 65. Some people, though, if you have other medical conditions, may be recommended to get it previous to 65 years of age. For instance, if you had pneumonia, if you have emphysema or lung disease, you know, asthma, if you're diabetic, you know, so your doctor may give it to you earlier. And in that case, you would get it that time and one time 5 years later. So example, if you got the pneumonia shot when you were 58, then you would get it one more time at 63, and that would be all.
So what does the pneumonia shot actually do?
The pneumonia shot gives you, it's also not a live shot, but it gives you sort of exposure to that strep pneumoniae bacterium, and then you build immunity to it, so in the event that you get exposed to it, you won't get sick.
Very well. Mm-hmm. And, you know, you mentioned to me at one point that some of the reasons why we need these vaccines later in life is because we have vaccines now in the world, and we don't necessarily build up an immunity because we're not around sickness all the time.
Sure. That actually is a nice segue into the third shot we want to talk about, which is Zostavax, which is the shingle shot you hear about. That what you're saying is exactly correct. Nowadays, shingles tends to be a little bit more common than probably it was, you know, 10 or 20 years ago. And the reason for that is shingles, just as a little background on that, is actually a reactivation of chickenpox that you had as a child. So once you get chickenpox, it actually never leaves. It goes and actually hangs out in your dorsal root ganglion. And later on in life, it can come out. And that's why it follows like a particular nerve pattern and only be on one side, what we call unilateral. And it causes redness and blistering rash, can be very painful. So, but the point is, you know, when you get chickenpox, you're immune initially to it. But then over the years and decades, that immunity will lax a little bit and will go down. But so nowadays, we give the Zostavax to reboost that immunity. But see, probably 15, 20 years ago, children in front of you, like in a shopping line or whatever, would actually have chickenpox. So you would get a little bit more exposure so you'd keep your immunity up. But now, since children in general are immunized against chickenpox, you're not going to have that exposure anymore.
I see. So you aren't seeing as many cases of chickenpox showing up as you would have 20 years ago.
That's exactly right, in the younger people. That's correct. Because the kids are getting immunized.
I see.
Yep.
Now, I had chickenpox when I was young.
Sure.
So is it possible for me to have this challenge of having shingles later in life?
It is.
Because of that?
It is. So that's why the recommendation is for you to get this shingles vaccine when you're 60 years old.
60
years and older, yes.
60 years
and older. It's once and done. Yep.
Once and done.
And actually,
that's it.
you know, the shot in children is called Varivax, and in adults it's called Zostavax, but the Zostavax is about 14 times stronger than the children's version. So they're not interchangeable on any level, but anyway. But that, as opposed to the other previous two, the flu shot or the pneumonia shot, the Zostavax is actually a live virus. So that comes with other risks. You know, you cannot be immunocompromised if you were going to get that shot, i.e. if you had HIV, AIDS, if you were on chemotherapy for cancer, or if you were on steroids, something, or if you were pregnant. You know, these are, but that wouldn't apply, obviously, okay. to seniors, but,
no.
but
well,
the point is...
Well, you never know, that woman at 70-something, yeah, right?
Right, exactly, well said. But anyway, you know, what was I going to say? But the point of it is, you know, again, I think just, you know, discussion with the nurse going to give the shot, or the medical assistant, or the doctor, and they can make sure that you're appropriate. But in general, for the shingle shot, 60 and over.
And you had a fourth immunization you wanted to talk
sure.
about.
Good old tetanus. You know, you hear about tetanus all the time. In general, we recommend that shot every 10 years. Unless you were to get cut or step on a nail or can or something like that, then it could be as frequently as every 5 years. But the reason I wanted to bring that one up in particular is because pertussis, which is whooping cough you hear about, that actually has been more prevalent in the community probably over the last 10 or 20 years. So now it's recommended that up to age 65, one of those boosters actually has whooping cough in it. So it's called TDAP as opposed to just TD, which is the traditional tetanus shot you get. So after age 65, though, it's, you know, every 10 years you would get just a TD. But at some point before that, you also get the booster with the whooping cough in it.
All right, and most likely if you go to your doctor, he's going to know what to give to you.
That's exactly right.
Okay,
yes.
So you don't have to remember.
No, you don't have to remember all
acronyms.
Of this. The whole point, I think the whole point of this is just the idea that, look, just because I'm 70 years old doesn't mean I don't need any shots. There's actually a lot of, you know, preventative measures you can take where you get shots, which can really prevent some real serious illnesses.
All right, now, of course, probably the most popular we hear about out in the public is the flu shot.
Sure.
We are, you know, into March. At mm-hmm. this point, and some people think, well, I already missed it, it's too late, you know, should I go in? What's the deal there?
Not good, good question. Not true. Actually, peak flu season happens in February, but up to 20% of people who are going to get flu will get it in either March or April. When you get the shot, it does take about 2 weeks to build immunity, but getting the shot in March is still appropriate.
So yeah. If you get the shot in March, let's mm-hmm. say, will that possibly last you to the next March, or should you get another one before that?
You would get the new shot will come out in around October, and you would get that in October and November.
And that's
yeah.
going to include the most popular
from the previous year. So
and
that's why it's
why.
Important that you have to redo it. And even if you get the shot in March, getting it again in, you know, October and November is not going to be too early because it's going to be a different shot.
Very well. So. Okay.
And just as a, you know, as a side note, you know, there are certainly a lot of other vaccines that can be given, you know, to adults as well as to seniors. But in general, these four that we had mentioned are most appropriate, recommended pretty much for everyone. But, you know, depending on certain conditions you may have, other shots could be recommended. Or if you were going to do any travel, that sort of thing,
okay.
like outside the country. You know, a very good website you could look at would be the CDC website, which is www.cdc.gov,
mm-hmm.
and they actually have a map on there, like if you were traveling to Thailand or something, you can click on Thailand, and it'll
okay.
give required shots, recommended shots, and other, you know, general health measures to look at while you're doing
okay.
travel.
Okay. Well, we're just about out of time,
sure.
but a lot of seniors don't use websites, so can they
sure.
come to their doctor and say, hey, I'm going here? Can
absolutely.
You,
and any, even
them?
If the, you know, travel medicine is a really vast topic, so doctors themselves may not know, but the reality is they would all have internet access pretty much in their office,
right.
so could look it up while you're in the office. So have
right.
patience with them if they're out of the room for 5 minutes.
So patients have patience.
Yes, patients have patience because
okay.
they may have to look the information up themselves just to be sure,
okay.
you know, to give you the best guidance.
Well, we sure look forward to talking with you again. I know next month we right. might actually go through the background with you and in the office with you. So
I think that's a great idea, like sort of what an office visit entails, why we gather information,
okay.
what the medical assistant's doing for you, that sort of thing, and just help you through the process.
Sounds great.
Okay.
All right, everyone. Thank you so much. It's Young at Heart. I'm Rhonda Van Winkle with Dr. Harding from Canyon Gate Medical. We'll see you next month.
Welcome back to Young at Heart. We're at the Perump Nuggets with Assistant General Manager Jeff. Okay, say your last name one more time. Rapchin.
There you go. You
Rapchin.
Got it now. She got it.
Yay! I'm really good at, you know, messing up people's names,
that's
but that's
right.
okay. We're here with Jeff today because he's got several programs going on,
you know,
at the Nuggets.
We do. We're very fortunate today that we've got Project 5000 working with the youth of Perump. Behind me, we have 12 of our students here from Perump Valley High School. who are interested in, believe it or not, they want to dredge into food and beverage.
Wow.
And one of the hardest things on the casino side to be able to go into. But we're real fortunate that we're able to have them come down. We've worked with them throughout the course of the day.
Right.
They've met with Dina Babs, who's our director of food and beverage, and our chefs Bill Bitzer and Chef Kenner from the steakhouse. And they'll be able to walk them through the process of their careers that they're looking at doing.
And where did the program come from? Project 500?
Project 5000. It's a program that Lucy Ivins brought to me. It's something that's going all across the valley. They've put 5,000 kids into the workforce environment that have showed interest in some sort of field. And these young people here showed an interest in food and beverage. So what better place to bring them than the Nugget?
Absolutely. Where the food we know is incredible. We just had a wonderful dish.
Little tasty.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, a little tasty.
Chef Kendrick, incredible.
You know, the best part about this program is, I've been a food and beverage all my life, and I started much like the age of them at 14, is that we've been able to show them what it takes as far as the commitment to go into this industry. Those of you that come in and dine and have a great dinner and you don't see what goes on behind the scenes, behind the house, to know that the tension, the product preparation, the plate presentation, making sure that the orders are put in correctly, making sure that everything is healthy, you know, that we have a clean and sanitized kitchen environment to make sure that the product comes out fantastic. This is one of the things that we're able to show these young people and be able to go ahead and give them an idea of what the steps they're going to take in the career that they've chosen.
Okay, now how did they get involved? I mean, how are you all chosen to be in this program? Is it something you signed up for? Was there a process where they picked certain people, or it's just open to anybody and everybody at the school get involved with the project?
I was contacted and said, hey, Jeff, want to bring some kids down, and there was never a question of how many or what we're going to do.
Okay, so you
we just opened the arms up.
Mm-hmm. Right.
I was fortunate enough to run a foundation in Las Vegas called Chef and Child, where we did a lot of things for underprivileged kids, and to be able to give this information and to be able to show them what they have to look forward to is not only a commitment on my part, but a commitment on the part of our company. To be able to, I mean, hopefully we'll get some of these guys to come work for us. I mean, they're showing the passion and they're showing the abilities to come in here and create great product.
Is it a year-long project then that you'll be doing, they'll be coming here?
This is my first time with it. So I haven't dealt with it before. Okay. Lucy, like I said, Lucy came to me and said, hey, you know, we want to bring these kids in. We want to show them what you have to offer. And I just think it's a wonderful
program. I wish they had something like that for me, because I'm always interested. I love the culinary industry. I think it's incredible. And to have this now available to all the kids, especially with all the exposure you've seen on TV with all the Food Network shows, all the
and that's what drives
shows.
It. We talked to them earlier about, you know, what keeps us on our toes is these young folks here, because they're seeing all these great TV shows on the TV, and oh, they can do this with baking, they can do this. So we have to be on our creative edge to make sure we stay above it.
Yeah, do they have questions?
A lot.
A lot of questions.
Yeah, they've been doing pretty good. Their biggest interest are the banquet facilities. Mm-hmm. They're going to learn some more today about how to set up a banquet. After we finish this, they're going to actually set up a banquet today and service a small banquet that we have on property. But it's just one of those things that I got to commend Lucy Ivins, I got to commend the high school, that they're able to bring these kids out here to give them an idea, because at this point in their lives, there has to be choices to be made.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
And we, you know, we have people who are graduating this year, right? We have three that are graduating this year.
Oh wow!
And then,
so they could be apprentices during the summer. Are you going to have a program like that?
No, we don't have an apprentice program, but we surely have given them the advice and direction of where they can go. As far as
super.
The Community College of Southern Nevada has a great program, and so those are one of the things that we talked about today. But it's just, if you haven't been in food and beverage and you don't know what's going on, these young folks behind us are going to be able to really have a good taste of it today, and we're really
so you're excited. You all love the program.
Yeah.
You think it's a worthwhile thing to
tell them. What's the best part, though?
What's the best?
The food.
The food. It's the tasting, right?
Yeah.
It's making sure they taste.
Hey, that's why Al and I always love coming over here to do a show.
I understand that you have other things going on here.
You know, we just came back from Quartzsite, Arizona. We just—it was a 10-day show down there. It's the largest RV show in the United States, and if you haven't been there, it's very hard to explain the magnitude of this. We probably had 500,000 people walk in front of our booth over the course of 10 days. It was just a sea of RVs. And our goal was to get them to understand and know what we have in Pahrump to be able to drive them to the valley. Obviously, the Nugget doesn't have an RV park, but you know, RVers are a big part of our community.
Yes.
And they're a big part of every business owner's year.
And you bring them in, that helps the whole community.
We have to be able to, everybody
work
has
together.
To
right.
work together on this. We were very fortunate to work with Preferred RV, Tropical RV, and the Nevada Commission of Tourism, and our local tourism board was down there passing out stuff. So we had a really good contingency of people down there to be able to let people know what you can enjoy in Pahrump and the surrounding areas. Mm-hmm. Obviously, you know, we're the gateway to Death Valley. We all know that.
Yeah.
We all know about the date farm. But they didn't know about, you know, the racetrack. They didn't know about Mountain Falls Golf Course. Some of them didn't know about the winery. So these are all things that draw RVers to an area. Mm-hmm. What can I do after I park there for 3 weeks? What am I going to do for a day trip? Mm-hmm. So those are some of the great things that I think are going to continue to happen.
Right.
Yeah.
We're also just signing up the Snore race again. The Snore 250 is going to come back out in October.
And what is that?
The Southern Nevada Off-Road Races Enthusiasts.
Okay. All right.
If this is, for those of you that don't know or didn't know, the Pahrump Nugget actually won Host Hotel for 2010.
Wow.
Our first year as a sponsor.
Oh, that's super.
We had a great time. We were able to bring 107 race teams out. And I would imagine that we're going to bring about 180 this year coming up. I will say that this is another great thing for the community. At the awards ceremony, and the tourism board is now trying to help me track how much we brought in over October, but they brought $10 million to Laughlin,
wow.
was what the tourism board said in Laughlin, to be able to draw that much money and push the community. It's something that I think we just have to continue to do.
Absolutely. It sounds like you really enjoy your job.
We have fun.
I know Dina has a blast, and I think Kendrick is so happy to be here now.
You know, we're very happy to have Kendrick here. Yeah. I mean, it was a big choice for him to be able to came to us from the Red Rock Hotel and Casino to actually move to Pahrump. And take on Stockton Steakhouse.
Well, you came from a rather well-known large resort, casino.
I've worked at a few in Vegas.
Yes, I was trying to say. Well, I heard you telling the kids about the Mirage.
I was at the Mirage for 6 years, and I opened up the Orleans. And but we've had fun. I've been with Golden Gaming now about 8 years.
Okay.
And you started young also, like the kids here.
I did.
See what I mean?
Oh, wow, yeah.
I did. I started at 14 years old. And
what made you interested in this kind of thing? Was it anything?
It was the only place that would hire you at 14. You know, I mean, you get in a dishwasher pit and you try to move up.
But what about for someone like my age? Is it too late to get involved?
You know what? I'm going to tell you what. It's never too late.
I need a job.
It's never too late. And I will tell you that.
Can I be your assistant?
Once you catch the bug, you can't get rid of it.
That's true.
Oh, no.
I've been out of the kitchen now a couple years, and I'll still go back on the line when it's busy and flip eggs and help out.
But I just see you all having so much fun here in the Nugget, and I think that's what draws people coming here is because the essence of it is fun.
We're fortunate, though, and Al's been around me now for 4 years.
That's right.
That we're fortunate to work in an environment that we're able to know each other's first names.
Yes,
and
absolutely.
And we're able to have a good time and enjoy it. And if I'm in the weeds, I know that Dina's going to help me out.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the part that really, really makes it a family unit.
It does.
Like I was telling them earlier, you can build a beautiful property. You can put slot machines in there and a bar. And the driving force really is our service and our product.
And we've run out of time,
Jeff,
but I so appreciate you coming, and we'll probably be talking to you a lot more.
No problem. Thank you.
Time comes along.
Thanks, kids.
We'll see you later. Yeah. Oh, the phone number, Al.
751-6500, located at
160.
Come on.
Highway
681 South
Highway 372. 751-6500. That's it.
Thanks, kids. Thanks, guys. What do you think about all those young people at the Nugget? I think it's a great program that they've got going and, you know, utilizing their talents.
I think it's fantastic because the young people now have these opportunities today where before when I was joined up a few years ago, I didn't have this.
That's right. Absolutely.
You know, I think this is great.
It's great. Now, I also want to tell y'all, we forgot to give you a little earlier, Ira's email site.
Yes.
To be able to go on and see the notebook or all the great stuff he does, I guess. It's lunchtimewithira@cox.net. Got it.
Yeah.
So that's an easy one to remember, just
see
Ira.
Email. You can't yeah. see it on that email.
Okay, yeah. Oh, it's only email, but you'll get all the funny yeah. stuff on there.
So that does mean that it's lunchtime where he's having lunch.
Mm-hmm.
When you do
that. At that point.
Oh, okay.
Or you can lunch. Do it at
yeah.
any time of the
yeah,
day.
Yeah, any time of day. What? I mean, do it just at lunchtime.
Absolutely.
Yeah, okay.
So what do you do? What do you think about the Charlie Sheen thing? That's bugging the. Oh, well, we've
different.
Got 2 minutes, so don't even go there. We don't have enough time.
We do.
We do? We got to tell about what our on our show next week, and that'll take all
that's
of
a good idea. Okay,
5 seconds.
Then if there's any time left,
yeah, there
can,
you go.
We can go there.
Okay, so we've got Judge Lane. Everybody knows Judge yes, Lane. He's still yes. here, and he's going to be coming in on the show. Dental impact? Plant. Mm-hmm. Dental implant.
Right.
Impact. I said dental impact.
Institute.
And we have Mike at the coroner's office coming in.
Oh, yeah. He's good.
He's a little he's stiff, good. But we'll warm him up, you know.
No dead air.
I'm going to tell him about that.
No dead air. I like that one, Ira. See? We're going to put him on our payroll, Pat, you know. He can be our script writer.
He's a good speaker.
And if you're really, really lucky, Woody Woods will be back on the show with his magic fingers on the keyboard, and then maybe I might be, you know, vocalizing. Never mind. Don't forget Spring Fling Cowboy Fling.
That's right.
Thing. For the Pahrump Valley Arts Council, and that is
and
a benefit.
The Maverick. And
the Maverick, which both are coming up March 5th. You could do both. One's in the morning, one's in the evening.
Very good.
And I'm sure just you'll find out when. Pahrump Valley Women's Luncheon, that's going to be next Tuesday, March 8th.
Yes,
again.
Is this for women only?
Yes, honey. It's networking. Women networking to meet women to business-wise, you know, like.
Well, what about men meeting women
why don't you start something?
You know,
or why don't you just show up at the buffet that day?
That's an idea, then the women can see me.
Just like
say,
the time you didn't show up for the women's Wednesday night at the Nugget.
I didn't know.
He didn't go. Yes,
I
you
forgot.
Did. Well, okay, you're going to the next one. Anyway, we okay. have so much fun on the show. We hope you do too, watching us.
Watching us.
Because we can't help ourselves.
No, we can't.
No.
That's
it's just the way it is.
We are young
at
heart.
Have a great week.
Have a great week.
Join Lynn now, next week, for another entertaining and informative hour of Young at Heart. Have a good day.
Fairy tales can come true. It can happen to you if you're young at heart.